He knows nothing about sports, but he called it right. 38-35 was his final there with Kansas City winning the Super Bowl. And, of course, we have things to discuss now with Mr. Phillips regarding Darvish, Bichette, and Christian Javier. And he's, of course, our pal. We say hello to Steve. Steve, welcome. Nice job on the prediction. We'll get to that a little later on. And, of course, I want to hear some comments now on these extensions. I think the one that surprised me the most was Darvish. I mean, he's 37 years of age as it is. I know money is no object in San Diego. Little surprised, taken aback by that. Discuss that first. Go ahead.
Well, yeah, Chris, I think the thing that's a little shocking is to say 6 years for a guy who's that age. He's going to pitch to the age of 42. But that being said, I would have paid him 4 years at $108 million. And so, you know, $27 million a year, he's still pitching at an elite level. He's a front of the rotation pitcher. He still gets swings and misses. He still induces weak contact. He's healthy as can be. He's a workhorse of a pitcher, 30 starts last year. And so, like, I like the contract. And so they get to spread the money out over 6 years. It lowers the AAV, which is something that they're sort of flirting with, the luxury tax threshold number. And so there's a way that they set up the contract to get a couple extra years on it to lower the annual average value, to allow them to spend it on other players. Remember, at the end of this season, Machado's likely to opt out. Juan Soto at some point is going to need to be signed. And so they've been able to sort of manage this a bit and still get a front end of the rotation starter. I love Darvish. I think he's a great pitcher. Love to have him on my team. I like this deal for the Padres.
Yeah, great's a little strong, but okay. Good pitcher. Great's a little high, but all right, fair. That's Mr. Phillips. Number two, Bichette. Is this an indication that they got this deal done, they eliminate the arbitration, that you think because they have a little momentum, they seem to like each other, that we could see Bichette signing a long-term contract in a couple of years to sort of be a Blue Jay fixture for life? How about that?
Well, I don't know necessarily that I'm willing to say that it's going to lead to the longer-term extension to buy out free agent years. This takes him through all of his arbitration years, and it at least presents that there's a good working relationship. Because when they didn't make a deal and they're going to the hearing, I'm thinking, oh boy, this is not going to end well. And I think everybody up in Toronto, north of the border, thought at some point Bichette's going to leave. That this is an indication of that. So I think if there's a save within that, I think the big challenge is we saw all the shortstops get paid huge money this offseason. And Bichette's looking at it saying, well, I'm one of those guys. Why don't I get paid that way? And so I think therein it made sense for the team. Buy out the arbitration. Wait and see how he continues to produce. You can always pay him as an elite shortstop down the road. And so I think it's the right thing to do. But I'm not convinced it means he's going to stay beyond his arbitration seasons.
Well, they're both up, him and Guerrero, after 2025. Chances are they're not going to be able to re-sign both for $400 million apiece, correct?
Well, here's the thing. Why not? Like, this is a great market. When they're winning, they draw. They're the only team in Canada. And so I don't want to let them off the hook on that. I don't see why they can't sign both of them. Build a team around these guys for the future. At some point, Springer's going to come off your books a couple years down the road. And so, you know, yeah, they've invested some money right now, but they're under the luxury tax threshold. And so from my perspective, I'm not going to let them off the hook that easy. They should be able to afford both Bichette and Guerrero down the road.